Today, a VIAS introduction will be given by Pankaj Jha, Senior EMAG Solutions Consultant at VIAS. Pankaj Jha has 5 years of experience in modeling and simulation of different types of electromagnetics problems. He has worked in areas of antenna array, filter design, microwave and RF circuits from GHZ to THZ, EMI and EMC. He worked with SIMULIA Systems as solution consultant and was responsible for aerospace and defense and high-tech industry technical portfolios for CST. He's a graduate from Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi, IITD, where he studied radio frequency design and technology. With the introduction out of the way, we will get started with a brief introduction to VIAS. Pankaj, would you like to take over?
Yeah, Beatrice, thank you for introduction. Good morning and good afternoon to all of you, wherever you are in the world and you may be. So the topic for our webinar is like electromagnetic simulation for antenna application using CST Studio Suite. And the agenda. The agenda for our webinar will be like I'll be discussing on the introduction part, then we'll be moving to antenna design overview. And in this, we'll be taking with two application example, antenna for a smart projector and antenna for satellite. Then we'll move into antenna array design and then the antenna placement. And then we'll discuss about hybrid solver and we'll take a question at the last. So starting with the overview for the VIAS, our presence head office is located in Houston, and we are located like on Chicago, Montreal, Toronto, San Francisco, Detroit, and we have a global presence in India. We consist of a team of PhD and masters in electromagnetics, solid mechanics, fluid mechanics, and optimization and reliability, numerical analysis. And the industry what we covered is from like energy process, life science, transportation and mobility, high tech, aerospace and defense. We are a platinum partner for the SIMULIA system product like SIMULIA, including Avacus, iSight, EFISAFE, Tosca, and CST Studio Suite, which is our EMAC portfolio. Today's webinar will be mostly based on CST Studio Suite and the Opera, which is again low frequency application based EMAC solutions. Then we'll have Katia, Delmia, and 3D Experience. We provide like 3D printing and simulation services to our customers. And we provide automation and customizations. So if you see, like to our customer, we provide software sales, software training, engineering consultancy, PLM implementation, and automation. Whom we have added value to consultancy, if you see in the area of FEA, Delphi, Cell, FlexLife, Kinder Morgan, BP, similarly in CFD area, if you see Applied Material, Exxon Mobil, for data analytics, NASA, Halliburton, Gap, Samsung, so a lot of them players over here. And definitely in the software side for our sales part, you can see Hutchison, Wood Group, Hunting, GMC, and all. And the training we have provided to Boeing, Lockheed Martin, Schlumberger, so these are like fairly enough our customer areas. And related to aerospace and defense, like Boeing, Lockheed Martin, and all comes over there. So we do provide like on-site training, in-class training, and online training to our customers. We have an open house day and free Avacus support open house days on first Friday of each month. And we provide like instruction involved university teaching for like fluid mechanics, CST, computational mechanics, subsea engineering, and we have an expert in different field like from CFD, FEA, electromagnetic, to cover whole product life cycle. So why VIAS? So we have a cross industry experience, highly skilled workforce. It is not just a sales organization, and we are the authorized education partner of Dassault System. And it is one-stop solution for companies for software, hardware, consulting, implementation, and training needs. And we have a global presence throughout. So the main area what today we want to discuss for our webinar is like antenna design solution overview. In this case, if we take like the future technology and the future warfighting systems, if you see, now it is systems of systems. Even one aircraft itself is a system, but now when we are in the swarm formation or collaborative environment, like each aircraft will be talking to each other in warfare scenario. And here another system is like human and autonomous system, like drones are talking with the ground control system and other human military at the ground. And even at this side, you can see like miniature and swarming. So what is the main scenario? What we want to see is that the communication is the main enabling technology, and antenna is the critical component for this communication. So that that is the base of our webinar. And if you see, the antennas are everywhere, from aerospace defense to your commercial product, mobile phone, or the projector. If you have gone through IEEE Explore page, then if you see in 2019, the highest search after image processing is based on antenna. So the global scenario of reach of antenna is quite high, and it is expected that by 2020, the antenna market will be around 27.8 billion. So it becomes very important for RF engineer to design the antenna precisely, and where it has to be placed, then it has to function with efficiently. So if we see the evolution of computational electromagnetics, so fairly in 1999, we see like we could simulate like a simple patch antenna, because there was a limitation of hardware and the software developing at that time. And when we moved like fairly one decade above, then we see in 2009, it can simulate like a size of a linear array. And now in the global context, if you see in 2019, like we can simulate a full array, and then array is placed on an aircraft. And after that, we want to see the install performance. So there is a lot of change happened throughout this 20-year period in electromagnetic computational domain. Now, if you see, the electromagnetic simulation tool are used for antenna synthesis and integration analysis on platform. So first we start with like antenna element design, then we go for antenna array, and then we go for antenna placement. Means antenna are placed on an aircraft, and then we want to see its install performance. So CST antenna design solution, if we see, the prototyping can be done with like antenna makers. After the prototyping, there are other ways for doing prototyping of antenna, but in today webinar, our main focus will be on antenna makers. Mostly, if you see over here, like antenna makers, it is a designable database of around like 400 antennas, where we can choose a suitable design candidate for our application very quickly. And after that, that antenna we can take into the CST environment, we can modify the geometry, we can optimize it, and we can place like radome. In some cases, like if we have to place the radome or the outer covering for the antenna, that can be done in the CST. And then that antenna is going to be placed on any platform. Platform can be your watch, it can be your car, it can be like aircraft, or it can be missile. And then we have to see the overall performance, the antenna in free space and antenna performance when it is placed on a platform. And we know that like Antennae will be not acting alone. It will be in the system environment. So we should able to do with both Antennae with the other systems, like it will have a power divided network for feeding the Antennae array, or it can have like other circuitry together. In that context also, whether we'll be able to take that challenge or not. And in the CST Studio Suite with SAM assembly and modeling, you can perform like system and circuit analysis together with the Antennae. Now your system can be going into the undue environment where the temperature may be high or some other charge particle effects. Then we have to do the multiphysics analysis. In the later part of our webinar, we'll be discussing more on that. Now, let us take like Antennae prototyping with Antennae makers. So here you can find the multiple Antennae option. You can design for your specification and perform the preliminary evaluation. After that, you can export into the CST Studio Suite. You can add the ROM is in this case, and then you can see the full performance. And you can, after getting in CST Studio Suite for full performance, you can even store it in a new template, even in Antennae Magus, like you can use it for other cases. Now the Antennae construction, which I was discussing, can be done through Antennae Magus. It can be even done through our CAD tools like DSKTR SolidWorks, which is also a part of the Dassault system tool. And the CST itself has a 3D modeling intuitive environment where you can do the construction of your Antennae. Any of the means you can construct it, and you can do a system level simulation, and then you can see its parametric analysis for the Antennae. But today our main focus will be how to get an Antennae from Antennae makers, then optimize in CST and see the install performance. So if we see from the application categories point of view and selecting the solvers, so CST offers like 20 altogether solvers. So among them, like Microwave Studio offers 7 solvers. So in that case, if you see, like when your Antennae size is large, it means like electrically large, like 20 lambda and 50 lambda, and wider bandwidth, then we choose time domain solver. But when your Antennae is like fairly equivalent to the size of electrical length, means fairly equivalent to 1 lambda or going up to like 5 lambda, and it is highly resonant structure, then we choose like frequency domain solver. Now the case can be like Antennae is on aircraft, or it is like we are trying to simulate a large reflector with a horn. In that case, like your fairly size will be going up to 1000 lambda, then we can select integral equation solver in that case, which is based on method of moments and MLFM. But there can be an environment where you have an Antennae on a seat and the size of your problem can go up to 10,000 lambda to fairly varying from 5,000 lambda to 10,000 lambda. Then we suggest to choose an asymptotic solver, which is based on shooting and bouncing ray technique. Now, so these are the application areas which I try to cover it. If we move into the CST Microwave Studio solver choice, so altogether the main solver, if you see time domain TLM, frequency domain, integral equation solver, asymptotic solver. Apart from that, other solvers in Microwave Studio are eigenmode solver, multi-layer solvers, and in integral equation solver, there is a CMA solvers. But if you see like all these four solvers, they are a full wave solver, and they are based on like volumetric mesh. Time domain TLM and F is based on volumetric mesh. Integral equation solver is based on surface based mesh. So the meshing will be only with the object boundaries. It will not do the meshing of the air space between if it is a horn and reflector. And the asymptotic solver, which is also a surface mesh, it is based on SVR technique. But if you see the time domain solver, which has like conformal meshing based on hexahedral mesh, and this conformal meshing PBA technology, perfect boundary approximation, which is our patented technology, it can handle large size problem, and it do not have like inconsistency with importing the model. Like if you have a model which is designed in like a complex model, let us take a tank, and that tank is designed in let us take CATIA or SolidWorks, and it will be a very large model. And if you want to import it into the CST Studio Suite and you want to hex mesh it, then time domain solver can easily handle it in that category. Now, in this webinar, we are taking two example application. One is BME, the smart projector. In this, if we see like this BME, the BME is like around the size of our A4 size paper, but the thickness is bit more. It can directly connect to the cloud through a Wi-Fi or the Bluetooth and a streaming. So we can, like a professional can easily take this projector into a bag and anywhere they can present it. But here the main challenge is with the dynamic product design cycle, where your other like structural mechanics team, FEA team will be working on the framework of this BME. So in that time, like RF engineer has to come up with like where to keep the antennas. And if we see here, like the height of this BME is 190 mm and width is 324 mm. And here if we see, like we have a projector unit, then we have a two battery unit, then we have a speakers, then we have a electronics inside it, then the aluminum frame. And we come up with like, there are only some space over here which I can keep the antenna. So antenna design engineer has a challenge of a space constraint, and with this electronics it should function well. So in antenna makers, you can go into your specification, you can custom your specification, or you can search like whether if you are working in WLAN area, then you can go for like ISM band at WLAN 2.4 gigahertz, and then you can smartly make it like compact integrated antenna by clicking all those icons and WLAN, then it will give you like 33 templates. So these are the antenna which it is suggesting you as a smart tool to you, like to choose from here. But we want like more constraint to given. Like I want like omnidirectional pattern. Like I'm trying to give it the output criteria to the antenna and trying to get like which is the best design candidate for my application. Even I can give the space constraint. Like I know like I have this limited space and I want to fit antenna in that space, then I can give in X direction 10, Y direction 10, and Z direction 20. So accordingly, it will try to search the antenna. And now if you see here, like you are, when you have given all those constraints, you are left with 22 antenna. Among them, we have to select the antenna. Now, once we select this antenna, then we have to also think not only the size constraint, we have to think from the performance point of view. Now this antenna will fit in our environment, but it do not have a better performance that you can odd even out in antenna makers. Here, if you see, it has a good performance, but it will not fit because it is not in X direction, it is a bit larger, means 10 mm more larger. But if you see this case, which is like off the shelf antenna, and here it is not fitting, but it has a better performance. And how we can reduce the size is like you can tweak like relative permittivity in the antenna makers, and you can come up with like it is the size is now within the limit as we expected, and it has a better performance. And we can see at like 2.4 gigahertz, like its reflection coefficient is around minus 20 dB, and it has a better bandwidth of like around 2 to 3% in this case. Now, so we don't want to limit ourselves with only one design candidate. We want to make odd even odd with multiple candidate, because it was suggesting you 22 antenna. You can select among them like 5-7 antenna and try to within the antenna magus GUI, you can simulate it and compare all together with add and compare tool inside the antenna magus. And from there, you can see like which has better bandwidth, which has better radiation characteristics like reflection coefficient, which has better gain. And from there, you can select one. If you want to make as an array, like, or if you want to make it as a antenna on certain environment, like in this case, we are trying to take one or two antenna on a BME and then trying to see it, how its performance is. So here clearly we can see like antenna six, or which has like better reflection coefficient with fair amount of bandwidth. Again, also antenna two, which has a better bandwidth with better reflection coefficient. Like these two antenna we can choose and we can place on our BME. So now we have a challenge, like one model is coming from Catia and one model is coming from antenna magus. We have to integrate both the model in CST Studio Suite and do the EM analysis. And here, like from the antenna magus, whatever the model will come, it will have a good meshing around, like snapping of the meshing. If you see the perfect here with our time domain hexahedral mesh, and near to the area of a port, we have to mesh properly so that we can capture all the electromagnetic field intensity. And here, if you see on the device CAD, like you might have like some details, like very minute details, but we don't want to capture all those details because it will not be useful from the EM point of view. But we want to like have a coarser mesh over there. But from the EM point of view in antenna, we have to have a denser mesh. So the time domain solver with perfect boundary approximation, you can achieve this. And you can see here, like where you have an antenna with two ports, here you have a denser mesh, and the region where you have like other 3D CAD. So the mesh has been kept a little bit coarser, so that your overall mesh count should not be much, much larger, and you need more memory for simulating your problem. And if you can see fairly like in one mesh cells here, like 2 to 3 material has come into account, and the PVA meshing can deals with this complex CAD, and it can fairly take into account for simulation. Now, if we see this problem at 2.45 gigahertz, we have simulated in 11 minutes on laptop, and the memory is, use is 1.2 GB. And this is the electric field magnitude at 2.45 gigahertz. If we are seeing the antenna on the left hand side, similarly, if we can see antenna on the right hand side, I have taken two antenna placing so that it can cover like full efficiency, means it has a total scan pattern. So using two antenna, we are trying to do it. Now, for these two antenna, we have to find the antenna gain. One antenna we have to switch off, and then we have to see the gain from this antenna. Again, one antenna we have to switch off, and we have to see the gain from this antenna. And then we can find the total scan pattern and the overall gain. Antenna one, if you see, the radiation efficiency is 85.6%, and for the antenna two, the radiation efficiency is 90.5%. Now we have, after combining the recording the maximum gain on each direction, we can get the total scan pattern. Using the post-processing template in CST, you can achieve this pattern. And you would also like to see this total scan pattern in 2D plot. So the variation of theta from 0 to 180 degree, and the phi from 0 to 360 degree. And this is the center point from where you can see like how the radiation is happening. And you will be interested to see the coverage efficiency of the antenna. And the coverage efficiency, if you see, defined as a coverage solid angle to the maximum solid angle. The maximum solid angle in this case will be 4 pi steradian. And we'll try to compare how the coverage efficiency with the isotropic radiator and the half wave dipole antenna and half power gain. So in both these cases, if you are trying to see, if you have 100% of 0 dB coverage efficiency, then your antenna combination is better than an isotropic radiator. 0 dB is better than the isotropic radiator, and 2 dB is for half wave dipole peak gain. So we can compare the coverage efficiency with respect to the isotropic radiator. The next application for I'll be choosing from aerospace defense industry. Previous application was on like from high tech industry, like we can have like antenna on mobile phone, like for 5G areas, and now for the aerospace and defense industry. Two industries are very different from different perspective point of view. Now, if we see antenna for a satellite, we have like different antenna for different purpose serving on a satellite. We can have telemetry, tracking and command antenna. We can have a GPS antenna. We could have a slotted array antenna. And we have like uplink and downlink antenna on a satellite, and more antennas on the satellite. And for this also case, we'll use an antenna magus, try to search our design candidate in antenna magus, and then we put that antenna on an on a satellite and see the performance, install performance. So the first is like input the design requirement in antenna magus. Like we can give like, okay, I'm working in radar bands. So in the radar bands, it can suggest you this is the antenna for your case. Or if you are working in aeronautical band, this is the antenna in this case. Or you, or user has a flexibility to do a custom specification. Then we can select the antenna candidates among like suggested antenna. Then we can estimate performance and tweak the design. And one of the main thing, it antenna measures to magus will give you the physics behind the antenna. It will give you a design guidelines, like very handy. If you see, to increase the gain, you have to increase the number of turns. So now in antenna magus itself, you can tweak the number of turns and you can see the gain increment. And then you can move that antenna into your CST design environment for install performance and export the parametric model to the CST microwave studio suite. And one best thing with the antenna magus is like you will be getting a parametric model in the CST studio suite. Now you have an option to parameterize, do a parameter sweep. If you know like the resonance frequency will save by changing the length and width, and then you can optimize your antenna for exact radiation pattern. So in this case also, we have taken all the six antennas over here, five antennas over here from antenna magus. And then in the assembly environment of CST, we with the 3D model of the satellite, we are trying to integrate it. And with the assembly, with the one click, you can, using the anchor point on the satellite and anchor point on the antenna, you can fix the antenna at the exact location where you want it. And then after that, we have to see the performance. So antenna over here, you can see depending upon the application, whether it is a broadband or whether it is like a resonant structure, we can choose the frequency for solving the antenna, means solver for solving the antenna, the time domain and frequency domain solver in this case. After that, we have stored its near field in both this case. This near field is placed on an antenna on the satellite, and then we use the integral equation solver. So we are doing like a hybridization of the solver. We are not only using a brute force simulation approach in this case to come with the performance of a antenna when it is placed on a satellite. Now, other parameters, like if you want to see, there are a lot of antenna on a satellite, so you want to see like antenna to antenna coupling, then you want to see how is the polarization and all, how is the polarization purity. So those type of output you can process using a post-processing template in CST Studio Suite. Now the talk on the phased array antenna. As we know that phased array is ubiquitous, it is everywhere. Initially, when the phased array came in 1980s, it was mainly for a radar for aerospace defense applications. But as the time goes on, we come to know that this phased array is applicable for other applications like 5G. It is main driving technology for 5G, even for the space. If you want high gain and to communicate to the ground station, you can see the antenna like a phased array on drones for high data rate for communication, and even on like ADAS, autonomous driving based. Here we have a sensor of radar sensor for that also. And if we want a multi beam and we want to trace like our obstacle before, then also we need a phased array. So in CST environment, how we can design a phased array? Let us take for one example, like for in-flight connectivity, nowadays we also have a phased array on aircraft. And this phased array is has to maintain a line of sight with the satellite. And we know that your aircraft will be moving and the satellite also will be rotating, and it can lose the line of sight. So we cannot mechanically on the top of an aircraft steer our antenna to with the other satellite, because it can break the aerodynamic behavior of the aircraft. So we have to think about, as an RF engineer, like we have to do a electronic beam scanning. We have to steer the beam electronically, and in that case we have to choose as a phased array. And to make a communication link established all the time during the flight. So in this case, if you see, first we start with a single element in a CST environment, and then we can do a unit cell analysis, which can be for unit cell analysis, you can use frequency domain solver to optimize your antenna for all the scan angles, and you can get active element impedance and active element pattern. So how your antenna is behaving for all the scan angles. Let us take, I want to scan from minus 160 to plus 60 and how it is behaving. And then we have to move for full array synthesis, where it will be a finite. In unit cell analysis, it will act as an infinite array, but in real world scenario, you have to see for a finite array case and for exact scan angle, what is the gain you are trying to get, and what is at this scan angle, what is the gain and how the performance of antenna will be. And now this antenna has to be placed on an aircraft, but we can see that in CST environment, you can trace where is the array task. It is in the home window. And if you go to the simulation project, you have an array task. And inside that, you have a different shape, custom shape, and diamond shape, and all. You can give element in X, element in Y, and different spacing between and the grid angle. And you can form your array and do the simulation. And similarly, here you have also an option to bring a TSP file, which we will discuss now. In some point of time. Now, when this array is placed on an aircraft, we want to see the performance of this array when it was in free space and when it is on aircraft. And we have to make sure that array performance should not deteriorate than the free space. It should be same. So, and in this case, if you observe it, like the problem size, you have like 2000 lambda, and you cannot solve it with one solver, like brute force approach. So you have to solve the antenna using time domain solver, store its near field, place on an aircraft, and then use the asymptotic solver, which is based on shooting and bouncing ray technique to get the solution. Antenna measures is also has a array synthesis part. So here you can take like linear array, rectangular array, circular array, and concentric array. Here you have a flexibility, like you can give your output specification. Like I want this much gain. Let us take in this, I have given a directivity of 26 dBi. I want the side lobe level to be, let us say 15 dBi, 20 dBi. Then it will suggest you with the distribution matrix layout. So this distribution matrix layout, if you see with one element, it will give the position of that element with X, Y, Z coordinate, and its amplitude and phase. Now this distribution matrix can be exported into the CST using a TSV file. That will be a CSV file. What we have to do is that we can bring into the CST design environment, and accordingly with our single element, it will place like where that has to be. And in this case, we are trying to find a null in our roadside direction with appropriate excitation pattern. So in this, like with giving the magnitude and phase of the excitation, we are trying to find the null in the at this point at the broadside direction. And so the way of doing that, I'll try to achieve the gain of like directivity of 26.5 dBi. So I have given the output specification, and antenna magus is smart enough to give you a distribution matrix of like the position of the antenna and the spacing between the antenna, such that you can get the desired gain. And you have to choose your single element such that you can achieve that much gain. Now, again, the antenna is installed on environment. Here it is a ship on the mast of the ship. Now the, you see the electrical size goes up to like around 6,000 lambda at 12.6 gigahertz, and its length is 1.153 meter, and it has hundreds of element in it. And we have a problem, like the size of antenna compared to the aircraft is very, very small. It order of magnitude three less. Then whether it will miss, if we use a brute force approach, whether it will miss the antenna nicely or not, or how the missing will happen. So the best way to do this type of problem is using the hybrid solver approach. We'll talk more about hybrid solver approach. And here, what we do is that first we store the near field of antenna using time domain solver. And that near field we keep on a mast. And then use the asymptotic solver to get its far field pattern. And we want to try to see like array performance when it is in free space, and array performance on the ship, and it should not change. And we can fairly see here in our polar plot, like it is almost matched. So what is the workflow for antenna install array workflow? If we want to see like element design, we have active element and active element pattern, active element impedance and active element pattern. Then the array design layout, we can do a real scanning behavior. This is for non-periodic structure. This is for infinite planar structure. And this array, when it is placed on a platform, then we want to see like how the performance will be. And if there are other antenna on that, how the antenna to antenna coupling will be there. Even you have a flexibility, like you have like a, sometimes a conformal array, then using a TSV file, you can bring your conformal array into the CST design environment. If you have like XYZ coordinate where the each element of array will be there, and we can bring into the CST design environment. So for antenna design and integration summary, if we see, we have a full range of solution techniques that gives greater flexibility. Single environment, which is critical for antenna integration and efficient workflow definition. So here in same GUI, using the same assembly and modeling technique, you can solve multiple antenna with different solver, like time domain, frequency domain, or integral equation solver, store its near field and far field depending upon the application, and move that near field and far field on the platform, which can be aircraft, which can be like BIMI in our today webinar case, and then see the radiation pattern as a for a full problem. So as throughout the webinar we were discussing about antenna placement and hybrid solver, so what CST offers in this area. So if you see, fairly enough, for antenna placement, a user can use a single solver approach. Either we can use like time domain or integral equation solver or brute force approach, where you can keep a sheep with all the antenna together in one environment and simulate it. Here you have a problem of electrical size. It will take more time to simulate, or you need more GPU computing. Like in this case, with the electric, with the sheep, with antenna together, it has been simulated. It can be simulated with one GPU. But if you have a multi-solver hybrid simulation approach, where you can first sold the antenna and then place on an aircraft and then try to get the antenna placement, means its radiation pattern and antenna to antenna coupling. So you are reducing the computational effort so that you can get your solution in considerable amount of time. Now, from the single solver approach, also our main design goals will be to get like radiation pattern and antenna to antenna coupling. And from the multiple solver approach also, it will be there. The benefit of using maybe like the time. And also if you see here, we have a two approach over here, is the unidirectional and bidirectional approach. And with the bidirectional approach, what is the, like how we'll achieve like our design goals? If you see in the hybrid solver task of the CST Studio Suite, we can choose the bidirectional as a mechanism for antenna placement. And here you can give a global iterative solver where you can give the number of iteration depending, like 5 iteration, 10 iteration, depending how much accuracy you want in your far field. And it is a fully automated SAM-based workflow. And it is included in CST environment at no extra cost. And if you see at the dynamic runtime, both the solver will be talking to each other. And what is the residual, relative residual, it will try to get it below like below 1%, or if you want to get it below like 0.005. So at that point, your stopping criteria or the number of iteration which is reached, it will stop. The solver will stop. Now let us take a case of reflector antenna with complex feeder. Here, brute force approach with T is prohibited due to volumetric mass and the dispersion effect. Like when the wave will come and hit on this, when the wave from this horn hits the reflector, and from the horn when it hits the, when from the reflector when it hits the horn, there can be a dispersion of the wave. And in that case, we are losing the far field signals. So in that case, we will not try to use the brute force approach. Or even like brute force approach in I is prohibited due to complex feeder. And in this case, we are only left with like we have to use the hybrid solver approach. And in the hybrid solver approach, you can use unidirectional approach or bidirectional approach. If you see the bidirectional approach, yeah, with core i7 laptop, the time taken here is 33 minutes. It has used 5 GB of RAM. Here it has used like 6 minutes with 4 GB of RAM. But the performance wise, the result wise, your bidirectional approach will be more accurate. So that we'll try to see here the far field of this. In this case, you see the red indicates with the bidirectional solver approach and the green indicates with the unidirectional solver approach. And you can fairly see here, there is a difference of side lobe level. So the bidirectional solver approach has predicted like the side lobe level is more, and it is exact with the measurement if you do. So the side lobe level is more. So you can get a better performance with bidirectional approach. And if you want to see the near field and the far field, that is also possible. This is the far field in your polar plot. And if you want to see near field at 22 gigahertz, and that you have to set the monitor in the CST Studio Suite, and with that you will be able to see. Now let us take a case of a slotted waveguide which is inside the aircraft nose pin radar. And this is a radar, and it is covered with the outer covering of an aircraft nose, and we want to see the performance. So first we'll do like a hybrid solver approach and then the unidirectional. Both we are comparing how is the result with the hybrid solver approach and unidirectional solver approach. In this case, you are you will see like with the bidirectional approach, you have more accuracy. And but if you see like if you want to do like for a shorter time and you want to see how the performance is for my antenna, then you can use a unidirectional solver as a intermediate approach. And And you can leave after some time. Okay, if you are satisfied, okay, I'm getting this much gain and I want to say more accuracy in result, then you can use the bidirectional server approach and you can leave your simulation for a certain longer time. Of course, for this type of problem with use of a time domain solver and use of integral equation solver, you can get your solution within fair amount of time, within like 5 to 6 hours. Now, the other problems like antenna can face, like it will be in the undue environment. Like in this case, you can see like your antenna is exposed to 323 Kelvin when it is on the space where do you have a direct sunlight and it is a reflector. So it can expand and your RF performance can deteriorate. So in CST, you have a thermal solver, conjugate heat transfer solver. Through that, you can what is the power loss and with that you can see like what is the heat generated on the surface. That heat we can capture, that heat you have to transfer into the structural mechanics solver. Structural mechanics solver will give you the deformed mesh. That deformed mesh again you have to give to the RF solver, and that will tell you how much there is a variation from your initial, and you have to take a counter measure like compensation technique beforehand, so that when it is placed into a critical environment, it should work better. So the multi-physics approach for antenna can be catered. And another thing, like if you see in the space environment, or if you are using a very high power devices, because of use of the high power devices, what can happen that it can, the metal of this antenna can knock out the electrons. If one electron is knocked out, it can hit the other part of your antenna and it can knock out more electrons, and it can create an avalanche effect, like which is being shown over here, what is called a multipaction, that can block the main stream or the main channel of antenna from where your wave is going and your data transfer is happening. So beforehand, we have to add the, as an antenna designer, we have to see whether if it is used for high power devices or whether it is going to a space environment where we'll have a different type of space charge effect that can particle in the space environment that can knock out our electrons. And then we have to choose a different material, or we have to choose such a way that whether it can withstand the power or not. In this way, if you see, as a CST, I want to conclude my talk. So it is an efficient antenna design tool with antenna megas. Antenna megas act as a smart tool for quick antenna synthesis and fully parametric export to CST for further analysis. You can do an efficient workflow setup with CST Studio Suite. Array task, if you see, all design stage with base solver in one environment. So you don't have to move like from one environment to other environment for doing. So one GUI, you can do like antenna and then the platform analysis together. Fully automated SAM-based workflow and bidirectional EM coupling between high frequency solvers. CST Studio Suite as a complete technology for one-stop solution for antenna design and microwave and RF components.